the love I could steal, beg or borrow. Wouldn't he?
Thank you. He's doing a boxing project.
6:30, 26 seconds, Saturday, 4th month, 8th date, 2000th year. Started the box project on Monday, the 3rd, 2000th of the year, at 10 p.m. I've spent the week in the box. And it's 6:36, 47 seconds on the 8th. I guess my skin is oily. My hair is stuck to my head. My clothes have pretty much rotted to my body. My socks are wet, my shoes are wet. I'm cramped, I sleep in a fetal position every day. Every night my knees hurt. But I like it, it doesn't bug me. It's safe in here. So, this will all end tomorrow at 10 o'clock. It will get out, it will be filmed and documented with still photo. And that's it. So, this is my tape for myself. Bye.
It's up to you.
person with you.
Big play, third down, 8 yards to go. Lorenzen now will run with it, try to get the first down, and he does. The big guy takes it all the way down to the Vandy 24-yard line, where it will be first and 10 for the Wildcats. Nate Morrow on the tackle allowed appreciates that.
One of the biggest cheers that had here in the last couple of weeks. And I tell you, it's exciting for Kentucky fans to be able to look and see those kind of things happening. Give it to go get it. Beat the guy you've got. Lorenzen has a spot where he wants to throw the ball on the field. They've practiced it week in, week out, day in, day out. There's the results of this offense when they get a chance to really be able to make a big play. And you've got the guys, as we touched on in the onset, that they have so many weapons. And you see, as we said, you've seen glimpses of Sims, but look at what happens when you have a chance to do that.
His second touchdown catch as a Wildcat, and for the first time in this game, Kentucky has the lead. 10-7 now, with 58 seconds left to go, first quarter.
Very intriguing.
Like an easy.
Well, I think it's very strange and new.
What do you think of Matthew?
Well, I just got out of the box, and I was wondering what it would be like to be in the box for a long time. When I first got in there, it smelled a little bit, I have to say. I wondered if it was me, and then I determined that it was the box. And there's duct tape in there, so now I am positive that men need duct tape. Like, because, you know, the few things you bring along, he's bringing duct tape. You know, there obviously there's a lot of duct tape on the box, so there's like repairs to go on. I'm learning a lot about this process. Yeah, several flashlights, because I don't know, I mean, when you're in the fetal position and you're like laying in the box, you're sleeping at night and you get scared or something, like, click on the light. How long did he live in there? I don't know.
That's what they're doing. really nice. But they hit hard over the skylight.
Really?
Black.
It was still
a
build up
going. Yeah, no, I think. And I shared my experience of getting in the box. It always takes me a little while to process in ways. I mean, I might do something different later anyway. But toilet paper, several flashlights, and I have to admit I cracked up a little bit about the duct tape. And then I realized I'm not that sure about the duct tape. I had to play on the cliche a little bit, like, man, just keep going. I don't care.